Hello, my dear students. I am Mrs. Hiba Hassan, and this is our fourth session in the story, Primary 3, Dr. Doolittle. Okay, before we start Chapter 4, we need to make a quick revise on Chapter 1, 2, and 3. Who can remind me? Do you remember the name of the town which Dr. Doolittle lives in? Yes, it's Puddleby. Okay, do you remember his favorite animals? Excellent. They are Tutu the owl, Jip the dog, Dab Dab the duck, Polynesia the parrot, and Gub Gub the baby pig. Good job. At the beginning of the story, Dr. Doolittle was a doctor for people and he changed his career to be a vet. Okay, can you remember who told them to do that? Excellent. He was the cat's meat man. Okay, Polynesia also encouraged Dr. Doolittle to be a vet, and she taught him the animals' languages, and she started with her own language, the parrot's language, and she taught him the ABCs first, then she taught him all the animals' languages. After that, Dr. Doolittle kept two special animals, which were the crocodile and the monkey. Do you remember the name of the monkey? Yes, excellent. He is Chi-Chi. Chi-Chi was dirty and unhappy monkey because he had a tight collar. The crocodile was also unhappy because he had toothache, and Dr. Doolittle made a favor for them. He cured the crocodile and kept him in his house, and this was a turning point in his life, because people start coming to see Dr. Doolittle because they were afraid of that crocodile. He became poor again and he doesn't have any money. So his sister insisted to send the crocodile away, and Dr. Doolittle refused to do that because he loved the crocodile, and the crocodile kept his promise, which is, yes, not to bite any fish or eat any animal. That's great. Okay, now Dr. Doolittle was a poor vet. He doesn't have any money. But suddenly Chi-Chi came to Dr. Doolittle and told him there is a big problem in Africa, which is all the monkeys in Africa were sick. Who told Chi-Chi about that? Excellent, the bird from Africa. Now Dr. Doolittle is ready to go to Africa after he borrowed the boat from, excellent, the sailor, because the sailor agreed to give him the boat because he cured his baby before. Are you ready to start the journey with Dr. Doolittle? Yes, because in this chapter, Dr. Doolittle will travel to Africa, and let's see what happened in this journey. Are you ready? Excellent. Let's read together. The journey to Africa took 6 weeks. So they were sailing on the boat for 6 weeks. Okay? The weather was very hot to Gub Gub the pig and Tutu the owl. So they couldn't face the hot weather there. They felt sick and tired. Do you remember when Dr. Doolittle told them that? I will not take you all because it's a hard journey, and he took only his favorite animals except, excellent, Polynesia. Yes, there was a bad storm and the boat was difficult to steer. What does it mean, the word steer? Means to turn his direction. Steer. Steer, to turn his direction. The boat hit a rock and the water came into it. Into it means the water become inside the water. Sorry, the boat. It was damaged. Okay, I want to show you something here. I have a boat and here we have a rock. When there was a storm, as you see in the picture, the sea is not stable, the waves are very high, the weather is not good, it is a storm. The boat was hard to, excellent, steer, so we can't change his direction. While they were sailing, the boat hit a rock. This is a rock. The boat hit hit a rock. So what happened if a boat which made of wood is hit a rock? What will happen? The boat will breaks, right? So this is what exactly happened. The boat broke and there was a hole down there. As you see in the picture, there was a hole. Okay, let's read this sentence. What there was a bad storm. The boat was difficult to steer. The boat hit a rock and the water came into it. So the water became inside the boat. What do you think will happen if the water come inside the boat? Do you remember that movie Titanic? Yes, exactly. The water became inside the boat. What happened? The boat will go down inside the water. So before we say that, Dab Dab swam under the boat and found a big hole in the bottom of the boat. As I told you, when the boat hit a rock, so there was a hole. Who will who find out that there is a wall, there is a hole in the boat? Dab Dab the duck. As you know, ducks can swim, so she dove under the water and she found down that there is a hole. Okay, as you see here, Dab Dab is our hero now because she's gonna do something, will help Dr. Doolittle in that. The boat was sinking very fast. Do you remember the word sink? Yes, sink means to come down in the water, to come down in the water. Very fast, and the doctor said that they must swim to the shore. What is the shore? The shore is the beach, okay? The sand. Chi-Chi and Gub-Gub didn't know how to swim. The doctor suggested an idea. Okay, so he has two animals which cannot swim. Who are they? Yes, Gub-Gub and Chi-Chi. Who is Gub-Gub? Yes, the baby pig. He found a long piece of rope. He tied one end to the part of the boat. He gave the other end to Dab Dab. Okay, here is the rope. Dab Dab took one side of the rope in his mouth, and then the other part. What they are gonna do with the other part? He gave the other end to Dab Dab and asked him to fly with it to the shore and find a tree to tie the rope to it. As you see in this picture, you can find the another part of the rope. The Dab Dab tie this rope to the tree and she has the other part in her mouth. Okay, what this will help? How can this help? Gub Gub and Chi Chi held on the rope and pulled themselves to the shore. They hang out on the rope and they try to move step by step to go from the boat and they will go to the shore. Okay. Dr. Doolittle and all the animals were all safe on the shore. So as Gub Gub and Chi Chi cannot swim, they found out a solution. They held on the rope and they moved to the shore. Who helped them to do that? Yes, Dab Dab. Okay, now all of them are on the shore or on the beach. They found a cave and the doctor suggested to stay in it till the storm ends. So they will stay safe inside the cave till the storm finish and the weather will become good again, so they can move and continue their journey. Dr. Doolittle's hat came off his head. As you see in the picture, when we have a strong wind, it can push anything. So his hat flown away. The doctor thought that the wind has blown it off. So Dab Dab went to see that hat which was floating in the sea. What does it mean, the word floating? I can show you. Can you see this cup? Can you see the small balls floating on the surface of the water? Yes, they are on the top in the top surface of the water. They are not inside. This is the meaning of floating. So the hat was floating in the sea. She found a mouse inside the hat. As you see in the picture here, there was a mouse. From where that mouse come? She found the mouse in the sea. She told the mouse that, where are you from? The mouse said that he was hiding on the boat. He was inside the boat and he didn't want to be left. Okay, all of them were leaving the boat as the boat was sinking. Okay, the boat was sinking. So he, the rat felt afraid that, or the mouse felt afraid that they will leave him inside and he will sink inside the water. So he was hiding inside the doctor's hat. Okay. He couldn't swim, so he got into the doctor's hat to be safe when the boat was sinking. Okay, we said sink is to be inside. Okay, look at these two cups. As you see, the balls in the first cup are floating because they are on the top, on the surface. But if you can see the coin here, it is sinking, so it is inside the water. Okay, do you think they will be safe after this strong storm? Can you guess what is gonna happen next? Let's see. Okay, back on the shore, a man came out of the jungle. You can see the picture of the jungle. A man came, okay, and walked to the cave. He asked Dr. Doolittle about who was he. He doesn't know who is Dr. Doolittle. So if I see a strange man, I will ask, who are you? This is exactly what the man did. Dr. Doolittle told him that he was Dr. Doolittle, or John Doolittle. He has come to Africa to cure the sick monkeys. So the doctor told him, I am Dr. Doolittle and I came here to cure the sick monkeys in your country. They are now in Africa. Yes. The man told Dr. Doolittle that he must come to meet the king. So if you come to a country or a place, you have to meet the people who are living there. This is exactly what the man suggested Dr. Doolittle to do. He told him that you have to come to meet the king and tell him, why are you here? So Dr. Doolittle and his animals followed the man to the jungle. Okay, so where are they going? They are going to meet the African king. So they were walking together, followed means to become after, to walk after someone. He is the leader and you will walk after him. Okay, they are gonna meet the king. What is gonna happen? You have to read. Don't forget to read the chapter in your book. Use the QR code to listen to the audio. It will help a lot. If you have any difficulties in some words, please communicate with your teacher inside the class. And you are welcome anytime. Thank you and goodbye.